Alright, hey guys, I've had a lot of requests on what people should prepare with, you know, for this corona situation. They just put out that they have a state of emergency in place in Washington and a state of emergency in San Francisco was announced the other day. So no matter how you feel about the situation, you still need to be prepared. So I don't like to tell people that and then not be prepared. You know, like there are people that just tell you all this just so they can get clicks and views and whatever. But I want to show you what I have prepared and things that you would, if you're going, you know, you need to be prepared. Things that you can use in any situation. You know, if there's a hurricane, tornado, grid down, EMP, martial law, a medical martial law. That's honestly one of my concerns, is that's what's going to end up happening. But you need to be prepared for any situation. I actually recorded half of this video at a different place where the bugging out to, sorry, my phone was ringing. You know, if a situation would occur, I just don't want everybody to know where it is or anything like that. So, anyway, my phone died there. So I have to record the rest of it here. Anyway, so let's get on what you need to be prepared medically. This way, if anything was to happen, I'm not telling you not to. I'm telling you, you wouldn't have to go to the hospital where all the sick people would be. You see what I'm saying? You wouldn't have to get out at all. We're preparing to where we won't have to leave at all. All right? So I'm gonna start off with, of course, my silver. It's not my silver, but this is not colloidal silver. Colloidal silver is acidic, and that is why I did so much research with this. And we've got the lozenges, the gel, the soaps, and everything. And I'll have a 20% off in my pinned comments. And this book, actually I think you can download the book. And it tells you all the things that we can't publicly tell you that it may or may not cure or prevent. It's absolutely amazing. Okay, moving on. For those who don't know, yes, I worked in the emergency room for years as an ER nurse. So I am likely more prepared medically than most people. And that's okay. You know, that's kind of why you work with other people. You know, one person's great at medical stuff. Maybe one person's good at, like, military aspect, like security and, you know, those type of things. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And so I'm going to go over some of the medical stuff and things that you can go and get at your local store and things that you can go get from an army surplus store if you have one around you. So I have this right here. It's got dividers and everything. And I have all the different types of gauze, all of these things that you would need for any type of wounds. Because you don't need to, if anything was to ever happen, you don't need to prepare just for the corona situation. You need to prepare in case something, you know, you're bugging out or whatever in your location or even at your house, whatever, and, you know, you break a finger or you cut yourself. You don't wanna have to go to the hospital where there are sick people with whatever Ebola they have going on when you can treat it at home, okay? And that's why I'm so much about the silver, because it does so many things. But I have IV start kits. I have fluids, like, to where I can actually hang fluids if somebody is in shock. You know, I have essentially everything you need. I could almost do surgery. I mean, let me see. I got some pretty crazy stuff, y'all. I have wound dressing, like this is used for wounds. I have sutures, things that most people really won't need. I mean, if somebody needs CPR and needs a nasal airway, I've got nasal airways, I've got oral airways, pretty much everything you would find in an emergency room. And I got all of this at a Army surplus store. And they have all of that. But, okay, let's get to some stuff that you can get at your neighborhood, whatever store. Get a blood pressure monitor because you want to monitor people's blood pressure to where you can take care of the situation, right? These elastic adhesives, bandages, used with this, cover a wound, any type of gaping wound. I mean, this is great for anything. I even have some pink ones, you know, for the kids that might be nervous, whatever. Regular, I call it regular, but hospital tape. The surgical kind, the flexible tape that, again, you can use your gauze and then tape up any type of wound situation. I have small ones. I have all kind of different size gauzes. I have the ones that don't stick to open wounds. Those are the best for open wounds, obviously, especially in sensitive areas. I have bleed stop. This stops the bleeding in particular areas. Now, whatever you have this stuff, don't just get it and don't be trained in it. You need to, if you have a friend that's an EMT or whatever, go get training from them. They have amazing videos online by, Skinny Medic. He has done amazing videos, but even he will tell you, go get the hands-on training because nothing can compare to hands-on training. Wound wash. Something you can just spray down the wound before dressing it. This is for IVs. Let me see. And then I have essentially anything you would need for a gunshot wound or a bad trauma. So I have tourniquets. I have the different types of actual wound, like this is everything you need for a bad trauma. Let me just say that. I'll say bad trauma. You can actually buy these kits online. And I mean, I think I got this one at an Army surplus store. But I love this one because the bag is just absolutely amazing. Then it has the reminder cards. So no, even if you're trained, you still want to have that because whenever your adrenaline's pumping and everything, you need some reminder cards, okay? An eye patch. I mean, seriously, like, anything that... everything. It's an amazing kit. No, you know what? I got this thing from Academy, I think. Yep, I got this from Academy. I believe. Let me not lie. I don't know. Maybe it was from the Army surplus store. But it is a great kit. It's got so many things. It has... I could go through it. I did go through it. I have a video about it. I'll put it at the end. And that way, you can go through all of that. But this has everything that you need. And it even has an extra holder for your weapon of choice. No, it's not loaded. I checked it. I might seem goofy, but come on, I'm not crazy. I know you guys are thinking, oh my gosh, she's crazy. Yes, don't handle a gun like that, okay? Don't do that. All right. This thing, absolutely phenomenal. What is it? It's a radio, but it's not just a radio. It's solar powered. It's got a solar panel. It's got a light on the back. It has an emergency thing, but it gets better. Not only is it solar powered for this radio, but you can plug in any of your wireless devices in here and then crank it. You can crank charge it. So, I mean, this is good for kids. Like, the kids are bored. Get a couple of these and have them, like, race. You know, like, who can charge the phone the fastest or their iPad? I mean, it could charge it with the solar too, but you have this as backup. So this thing is amazing. I ordered it from, I don't know. It's called FOS Power, FOS Power. I've got pepper spray, but it's pepper gel. It's not, it is Saber. This is the one that I recommend, Saber, because if you have to spray this at anybody, you don't want it in your face. You don't want it in other people's faces that, you know, if they have your kid or whatever the case may be. When you spray this, it's going to go on them. It's the gel, okay? My teenage daughter even has one, okay? You can put it on a keychain, whatever, but you just flip this up and you press it down, and this is the best stuff. Saber gel, okay? They even have a bigger, like, fire extinguisher size one to where if you have just, like, a mob of people. But anyway, oh, and here's a small tourniquet. Got all kinds of stuff in here. Who knows? Extra those. Another tourniquet. You know, and that's the thing. You need to learn about tourniquets before you use one. I mean, unless you're in a dire situation, you got one. Learn about the size difference and why you would need a certain size over a different size. But these are really awesome. These are the ones that the Army uses. The military, in general. Of course, scissors, surgical scissors. I have some in that pack, too. You want to have alcohol. Peroxide. You want to have your regular, everyday, normal meds. You know, aspirin, Tylenol, ibuprofen. You want to have some Vaseline. Let me show you. This is Vicks Vapor Rub. Well, it's the off-brand. But this has multiple uses. I know most people are thinking, oh yeah, the stuff you put on your chest for coughs and all of these things. Yes. But there's another use for it that most people don't think about. Like in the emergency room, we would use this if somebody came in that may have pooped themselves, or let's say you're dealing with maybe dead animals, we'll say that. If there's dead animals, you know, if you're in a bad situation, it's just a little something that's gonna, you're not having to think about that horrific smell. It's great for kids too, because they won't have to deal with this. And obviously this is in a crazy scenario, but if you're going to prepare, be prepared to where you have this for everything, okay? Because things just aren't looking good. I mean, I'm going to put my other video at the end that I spoke about what occurred in the Balkans. Was it the Balkans War? And how everything was just going fine one day, then bam. It wasn't. And, you know, it was like the West. Everything was going fine. It was like normal city life, okay? And then, bam, it wasn't. And it was bad. They were having to burn their furniture. They didn't have food. The Bosnian War. That's what it was. And so, you just put this in your nasal area, or just put it right here. And it helps you to not have to deal with the rotting smell of trash or anything else. But ibuprofen, oh, let me show you. I have the regular ibuprofen, but then I have gel tabs. There's a reason I have gel tabs. This is a separate, like, keep, you know, get your regular ones, like, you know, your regular ibuprofen. But I have these for a particular reason. You can take a needle and stick a hole in this and squeeze it into a tooth if you're having a toothache, and it works amazingly, unless you have, like, extremely bad, but this works. I mean, it, some people say it's better than lidocaine. It, you squeeze it directly into that toothache, it's amazing. Of course, your regular antibiotic ointment, your stomach relief stuff. You also want to get some Benadryl, and there's a few reasons you want to get Benadryl. First of all, if you have small kids and if there's a extremely bad situation, don't do this in normal life, okay? But if there's a traumatic situation that you're having to deal with, and they can't sleep. Again, do not do that in an everyday situation. Don't do that because you want to go drinking. That's child abuse, okay? I've got finger splints, which, I mean, these aren't extremely necessary. They're just helpful, especially if you're having to do a lot of things. You know, you don't want your, if you did break a finger, you don't want to have to keep hitting it on things. Just anything that's going to make it a little bit easier for you. I have lidocaine patches, like back patches. And, let me see. I've got a water, one of these Sawyer, the Sawyer squeeze. It filters like 100,000 gallons, I believe. And it's like 20 or 30 bucks. And you just connect this to any water bottle. You can connect it to, there's different connections that you can make for this. Because, y'all, let me tell you, I believe this stuff is in the water. That's kind of what the only reason that these random cases that don't seem to be connected to anyone, it's possible. It's very possible that it's in the water somewhere. So it's just something to, you know, have an extra layer of protection. Obviously, have bleach. I have 10, 20 gallons of bleach. I have gallons of water. If you have a swimming pool and if it's salt water, drain that and put fresh water in it right now. Because you people that have a saltwater pool are going to regret it. I'm just saying, if you don't. But I'm telling you, if there's ever a bad situation, when you have a pool, you have almost unlimited access to water. You can wash your clothes in it. You can take showers in it. Of course, it's not going to be like normal everyday life, but you have that water. You can even filter that water to drink it. But with that salt water, you're screwed. And, you know, people didn't think about that when they started installing all these salt water pools. So, obviously, let me say that this is, that's your last resort. But think about it. That's, what, 10,000 gallons? If you have a, like, an in-ground pool, that's 10,000 gallons of fresh water right there at your house. There's so many things that people don't think about in emergency situations. I also have essential oils. Look into them. There's reasons that frankincense and myrrh and other, you know, like sandalwood and cinnamon and things like that are in the Bible. It's because they actually use them to heal things because they prevent bacteria and those. I don't have enough knowledge on essential oils. Let me not say knowledge. I mean, like, comparing brands. I'm not going to refer any brands in particular because, that's your call. Research it. Okay. The only reason I did so much research on silver is because it does so many amazing things. And I mean, this prevents bacteria and stuff too. You can literally put this in paint and paint your wall and prevent mold from growing on it. You can put it in I have a little spray bottle and spray your carpets. You can spray your bedding. You can spray all of these things and it will kill bacteria, viruses, funguses, all of these things. I'm not going to say 100%, but I'll do a separate video on the silver. I have done another video with Dr. Pedersen. If you haven't seen that, check that out. But I was going to do more of an in-depth, kind of from a mom aspect, kind of from a just a regular everyday person aspect rather than kind of medically. And that's how we talked about it with Dr. Pedersen. Obviously, you want water jugs. All mine are at my bug out place. But I do have this one. This is a 5-gallon. And the reason I don't have water in it is because you can just carry it if you have to go find water. I just wanted to show it to y'all before I fill it up. But you can go, carry this light thing to the freshwater source wherever you have to go, okay? And I know people are thinking, oh my gosh, it's just like coronavirus, like, how is this? Y'all, we don't know. When they are implementing completely shutting down cities of millions of people, there's something to be concerned about, at least to be prepared. And like, you know, I've said in an older video, this isn't to freak anybody out. I'm prepared. I'm not freaked out. What does worry me are the people that aren't prepared. And the people that are going to try to come to me or anybody else that's prepared and have me look at your child or whoever's child in the face and say, sorry. Obviously, I probably wouldn't do that, but I would do it to an adult. But I mean, you see what I'm saying? You would make me into the bad person because you didn't prepare. Don't do that to people, especially if you have children. If you have children, you need to be prepared in the best way that you can. Zone bars, absolutely amazing. You can, and this one is awesome because it's the cookie dough and it can resist, you know, if it melts or gets too cold, whatever, it's still gonna be fine. So that's why I choose this chocolate chip cookie dough one. But this is one of the only ones that you can use as a complete meal. I know there's other ones, and if you like other ones, that's fine. It's just from my research, this one's essentially, I would say, on perfect for a store-bought one. There are ways that you can make some pemmican, I think it's called. And I'm looking into that. I want to make some of that because that seems phenomenal. It's what they used to do in the old days. But anyway, and they're little. You can have 100 of these just in a small pack like this. Well, maybe not 100, but you can have them in a big pack like that. You can have a few hundred probably in a pack like this. And, you know, so that way it's mobile. You can bring it wherever. If you have to leave, if you live in the city or around a whole bunch of people, you know, pack these up, have them ready. You don't have to have as much stuff as me. You know, this is accumulated over time. But definitely have these small amounts. Okay, now let's get on to the video that I did yesterday when my phone died. And I'm going to talk about the masks and gloves. Okay, so this is how your mask should fit. This should be tight around your nose, tight around the edges. And, I mean, if you are in a known infected area, you could even make it tighter. But this should be good. You know, like, you could put it a little bit tighter right here, but y'all might not be able to hear me. Okay. So, these are N95s. So, we've got N95s. These are N95 dust masks. These are super cheap. But you just need to be careful on how you make sure that you put this on tight. It doesn't have this extra filter on it, but it, you know, it will work. And I know the CDC and whoever is saying masks aren't necessary. Well, it's an extra layer of prevention. And honestly, it's not like a completely necessary, but are you going to take that chance? I would say absolutely. It's aerosol. Because if the government just bought 500 million masks, obviously masks are necessary. See what I'm saying? So, I think instead of them saying masks aren't necessary, they should say only masks are not necessary, because you need masks, gloves, goggles if you are in a known scenario where people are likely to be infected. You want an entire suit, okay? I have these masks too. I would say, you know, these are good for they're individually wrapped. I mean, if you're in a known situation, I wouldn't use this. I would use something that's tighter fit. These are more like surgical masks. Hold on, let me get one. All right, so got some gloves on. I would get some tighter ones, but I don't have those right now with me. But this mask right here, you see how it kind of moves up and down? Because it's not tight all the way. But if this is all you have, this is definitely better than nothing. And it's kind of cool looking. Please ignore the random deer on the wall. I'm from the country. All right, but no, if you have what you need to do,
you have an entire suit on, which would be ideal,
have the whole suit on, your gloves, and then you want to duct tape these underneath the suit, bring it down, and then duct tape the suit to your gloves to where you don't have anything showing, okay? You want some goggles, all right? Swimming goggles are absolutely fine because those actually suck right to your eyes to prevent your mucous membranes. So if that's all you can find, perfect, grab those. Especially for kids, you know, they're gonna mess with these, whatever. But again, I have different types of masks. I have the ones that I just had on. This one with the filter, with the cool flow, they call it. We have the regular dust masks that are N95 rated. Nothing is 100% proof. That's why you want to have as much as possible, protect as much as possible, you know, having a suit. And then what you need to do whenever you do have these things, okay? When you're wearing gloves, when you go to take them off, this is how you take them off. You grab the middle of this glove and then you pull it off, ball it up, and then you're gonna slip your finger underneath here and pull this. Now both the outsides of the gloves that would have touched anything are now on the inside and you dispose of it, okay? That's the best way to prevent anything from transferring that. And that's what's going on right now. I see, you know, people are like reusing masks and doing crazy things that it's like you might as well not even have any protection because you're just contaminating everything. Because viruses like this, and all viruses, can live on surfaces, porous, non-porous, meaning tables, anything. So you need to make sure you're washing your hands. Of course, get silver. Let me explain the silver that I'm speaking about for those who have not heard me speak about it. This is not colloidal silver. Why do I not recommend colloidal silver? Because it's acidic. Not only is it acidic, it's not structured. You know, some people recommend it, but I've done extensive research. On this, and as most of you know, I am an RN. I worked in the emergency room for years, so I wouldn't just randomly tell you something's okay. All right, I hope y'all enjoyed that. I didn't go too in depth because I just wanted to kind of do an overview. Sorry if I went too fast, but there are much better equipped channels that deal with these aspects. And let me see, like Patriot Nurse, Bear Independent. I know a lot of my viewers watch Bear Independent because I sent them there back like a year ago, because he does a great job. He's amazing. He doesn't sugarcoat anything, but he also isn't an alarmist, and that's why I really like his channel. That's pretty much the only ones that I would like. Let me see. I'm sure there's a few others, but I'll put the videos that I've already done, things about this, like how to store rice, how to pressure cook food and keep it in the sealed jars and things like that. Let me see, what else do I have? Yeah, that's probably it. I mean, just be prepared. Use your common sense. But get your silver. I mean, this stuff does many more things than prevent viruses and stuff, but that's pretty important. It's amazing. It's phenomenal. Anyway, y'all have a wonderful day. And there's a 20% off for that in the pinned comments. Y'all have a wonderful day. Like, share, and subscribe if you are not. Bye, guys. Mm-hmm.